Hello friends, welcome to GCA. I hope you all are doing good and preparing. So today's topic is Missile System of India, and this is a very important lecture topic, and also the questions related to this are asked in personal interview. For example, the interviewing officer can ask what is the range of Parikh missile, what is a BrahMos missile, what is a Nirbhay missile, and what is the difference between cruise and ballistic missile. And in lecture this topic is also known by its another name, which is the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. So if the topic is Integrated Missile Development Program or the Missile System of India, we need to cover the same data. So again, without wasting any time, let us start. So the Missile System of India comes under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, which falls under the Ministry of Defense, and our former Prime Minister Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, he was inducted into this program and he supervised the development of missiles, because of which he is also known as the Missile Man of India. So this Integrated Guided Missile Development Program was started to develop the wide range of guided missiles that provide Indian military with a stellar might, and also to act as a deterrent for China and Pakistan. Actually, this program started in 1980, and in 2008, in January 2008, DRDO formally announced that it has achieved its objective of developing the required amount of missiles after duly tested, and these were inducted into the forces. So there are two type of missiles, ballistic missile and cruise missile. And this question is generally asked, what is the difference between a ballistic and cruise missile? And for that, I'm coming up with a separate video, maybe by tomorrow. And the best thing about the missile system of India is all the missiles are indigenously developed. Although there are some missiles which are co-produced with the help of other countries, like we have produced BrahMos missile with the help of Russia and Barak missile with the help of Israel, but we have not imported any missile. So from this we can say that we have achieved self-sufficiency in the development of missiles. And now let us see the main missile arsenal of India. So the first is the Prithvi missile system, and it is a surface-to-surface short-range ballistic missile, and it was first test fired in February 1988. And it has three variants: Prithvi 1 with a range of 150 km and it can carry 1000 kg of payload, and it was inducted into service in 1998. Second variant is Prithvi 2 with a range of 350 km and it can carry a payload from 350 to 750 kg, and it was inducted 2 years before the Prithvi 1. And the third variant is Prithvi 3. It has a range of 350 to 600 km with the capability of 500 to 1000 kg of payload, and this missile was inducted into service in 2004. And the naval variants of the Prithvi is known as Dhanush missile. And the next system is the Agni missile system, and these are the medium to intercontinental range ballistic missiles. The medium range missiles are those which have range less than 5500 km, and the intercontinental missiles are those which have range more than 5500 km. It has 5 variants. The first is Agni 1 with the range of 750 to 1250 km and with the capability of 1000 kg payload, and it was inducted into service in 2002. And Agni 2 variant has a range of 2000 to 3500 km with 1000 kg of payload, and it was inducted into service in 1999, 3 years before Agni 1. And third variant is Agni 3, which is with a range of 3500 km and it can carry a payload of 2000 kg and it was inducted in 2011. Then the fourth variant, known as Agni 4, it has a range of 3000 to 400 km and with the capability of around 1000 kg payload, and it was inducted into service in 2014. And the most important variant of Agni 5, which is an intercontinental ballistic missiles, because its range is more than 5500 km, as I already mentioned, and it can carry a payload of 1000 kg. And it was first tested in 2012 and again in 2013. And talking about the dimensions of the missiles, this is a 17 meters long and it weighs about 50 tons. And the last successful test was conducted in December 2019. And this missile can target almost all of Asia, including China, Pakistan and Europe. And when the successful test was conducted, there were news in the media, like for the China, we have Agni 5 alone, like with the help of Agni alone, we can target whole of the China. Now the next variant of Agni, which is still under development, is the Agni 6, also known as by name Surya. It has a range of 8000 to 12000 km and it can carry around 80000 of payload. And as I said, it is still under development, and very soon we are going to have this in our inventory. So the next system is The Akash missile system is a medium range surface to air missile and it is a multi-target, multi-directional and all-weather air defense missile system which consists of surveillance and tracking radars for defending. So thereby with this we have added features of surveillance, which is the close observation, and the radars which can prevent any attack. It has a range of 25 kilometers and it has a supersonic speed ranging from Mach 2.8 to 3.5. And it has been inducted into the Indian Army as a short-range surface-to-air missile, and it was formally inducted into the Indian Air Force on July 2015. And the next is the Trishul missile system. It is a short-range surface-to-air missile with a range of 9 km with the capability of 5.5 kg of payload, and it is designed to use against low-level target. This is basically for the Indian Navy to defend the naval vessels against missiles. Next is the Nag missile system. It is one of the best weapon of India which is indigenously produced, and it is a third generation fire and forget anti-tank missile which is used to target even the modern third generation tanks, and it is an all-weather top attack missile with a range of 3 to 7 kilometers, and it is capable of defeating modern armors like explosive reactive armor and even the composite armor. Recently we have developed the helicopter enabled Nag missile with a range of 7 to 8 km, which is known by its name Helena, which means helicopter inducted Nag missile. And the first it is recently test fired from the army chopper, and it has produced best result. Next is the BrahMos missile system, one of the best weapon co-produced by India and Russia when both the countries in 1998 signed an agreement to design, develop and manufacture a cruise missile, and the target was achieved within 8 years. And talking about BrahMos, it is a supersonic missile that can be launched from submarines, ships or aircraft. So thereby it is held with all the forces including Army, Navy and Air Force. And BrahMos is the world's fastest cruise missile with a range of 290 km. And this testified in 2014 for the induction into the Indian Navy. And talking about the air variants, it was successfully test fired from the Sukhoi jet. And India became the only country in the world to have fired an air-launched surface attack missile. The BrahMos provide Indian Air Force a desired capability to strike from large standoff ranges on any target at sea or land with pinpoint accuracy by day or night and in all weather condition. So this is an all-rounder missile, the all-weather missile. Next is the Shaurya missile, which is a hypersonic missile, which is a highly supersonic missile with the Mach of 5. And it is a surface-to-surface tactical missile which is produced by DRDO in 2011. And this missile is believed to be designed specifically to be fired from submarines. So this is basically for the Indian Navy. And it has a range of 750 to 1000 kilometers. And it can fly at a low altitude and prevent detection by anti-missile weapon system. Next is the Sagarika missile, also known as the K-15. And this is indigenously developed short-range ballistic nuclear capable missile, and it is aimed to provide a retaliatory nuclear strike capability of India, and it has a range of 700 to 750 kilometers. Next is the K-4 missile, and it is a nuclear capable ballistic missile that can be launched from underwater platform, and it has a range of 2000 kilometers, and the first test was done in February 2014. And with this, India has completed the nuclear triad, that is, India have the capability of launching surface, air and underground nuclear capable ballistic missiles. Next is the Nirbhay missile, the most important, which is India's first indigenously designed and developed subsonic long range attack cruise missile that can be armed with 200 to 300 kg of warhead or the payload, and it can strike up to a distance of 1000 kilometers. So this is a very big achievement of India. Next is the Astra missile, which is the first indigenously developed and all-weather beyond visual range air-to-air missile, and it was successfully fired from Sukhoi jet in 2014, and it can hit a target at a distance of 20 km and to beyond 80 km with the long range. Next is the Prahar missile system, which is a multi-missile launcher system with a range of 150 km that have the capability to fire 6 missiles from its multi-launcher system, you can see from the photo. And it is carried by Tatra truck, which is transporter erector launcher vehicle. And the last and the most important, the Barak missile, which is co-produced by India and Israel, and it is a long-range surface-to-air missile. Barak is designed to deal with wide range of incoming airborne threats, and it can also intercept target as close as 500 meters away from the ship. And it has a maximum range of Mach 2, and its maximum range is around 70 kilometers, and this is one of the biggest landmark achievement in India-Israel relations, as Israelis are very good friend. It has always supported us. So friends, this is all about today, and I have covered each and everything of the topic in a very short time, and I hope you have gained something new from this. And as I said, that I will be making a separate video of difference between cruise and ballistic missile, so stay tuned for that video, and the video will be uploaded tomorrow. So thanks for watching this video, and if you feel these videos are worth sharing, then you can share this video with your friends so that more and more people join, and I will make more and more videos. So till then, best of luck, God bless you, and thank you for watching the video.